In this video, we're going to take a look at adding and modifying model dimensions in an Autodesk Inventor drawing. There are two types of dimensions in an Autodesk Inventor drawing. One is a general dimension that just simply reports the size of object. The other is model dimensions, which are dimensions that can actually be used to modify the model. Model dimensions can either be added when the view is created or they can be added after the fact. We'll first look at adding model dimensions while placing a view. I'll select my base view tool and set up my first view here. And in the drawing view dialog box, I will select the recovery options tab. Then I will select all model dimensions. Then click OK. As you can see, all the model dimensions for that particular view have been brought in. Alternatively, we can place model dimensions after the view has been created. So I'll go ahead and select my base view once again. This time I'm going to go to the Annotate tab, then select Retrieve Model Annotations. You can also select a view, right click, and choose the same option there. In either case, it'll bring up the Retrieve Model Annotation dialog box. And by default, it will go ahead and display all of the model dimensions for this particular view. If I go ahead and click OK, it will continue displaying all of the model dimensions for this particular view. Alternatively, I could select specific dimensions as well. I'll undo and retrieve model dimensions again. And this time I'll just simply select the dimensions that I want to keep. So I'll pick a couple of these dimensions here, then click OK. And as you can see, those are the only ones that remain. I'm going to go ahead and project a couple of additional views here. And I'm going to retrieve model dimensions again here. I'll select the top view this time, and you can see some of the dimensions that I had removed from the front view display now in the top view. Each model dimension can only be displayed once. For example, I can see the width of the part in this top view. If I try to retrieve the dimensions in the side view, you can see I get a couple of other dimensions, the height and the chamfer size, but I don't get the thickness of the part. If I delete the dimension from the top view and then retrieve again over here in the right side view, you can see that I can now access that dimension. So similar to the concept of not wanting to overconstrain a part, each model dimension can only be placed once. As you can see, it's going to take a little bit of work to clean up my dimensions to get this looking like a nicely dimensioned drawing. Since these are model dimensions, they can be used to actually change the model. If I select a dimension and right click, I have the edit option. This will just take me into the text dialog box. Instead, I'm going to right click and choose edit model dimension. That'll bring up a dialog box similar to when I'm in the part mode. Then I can go ahead and type in a new value here. As you can see, the part actually updated. If I maybe edit this whole dimension here as well, you can see since this one was a counter bore, it actually has a couple of different values I can edit. I'll just change one of the two values here and we'll see the part actually update. If I go ahead and save this drawing, it's going to save not only the drawing, but also the part that has been modified. And as you can see, if I open up this part now, I have the new sizes in here as well. So once again, to place model dimensions, you can either do so while you are placing the initial view, or you can use the Retrieve Model Annotations tool to bring them up as well. That concludes this look at adding model dimensions in an Autodesk Inventor drawing.